The last cigarette before heading out. Search and attack, they call it. The Marines move through the ruins of Fallujah, looking for any gunmen who've not fled or been killed. The most desperate and determined. Tanks rumble in. The Americans were in this neighborhood the day before, but maybe the insurgents crept back overnight. The Marines have been told to comb the mosque for weapons, and as they do, the firing starts. It turns into a firefight. The armored vehicle arrives with more ammunition because the houses around the mosque are full of fighters. A group of Marines is pinned down on a flat rooftop. We're filming from an armored vehicle on the street below. The heavier weapons fire a barrage at the insurgents. They call it suppressive fire. A Marine has been injured, and his colleagues need to administer first aid and get him out. A stretcher is brought. This is a serious casualty, and it may already be too late. But the rest of the group now needs to get out too, under intense fire. This is the most dangerous engagement India companies had in Fallujah. We weren't allowed to film the casualties. This one was loaded into the Amtrak and taken away. The fire team crosses the street.
Get on the roof!
Tell them it's coming up!
They're going to hit the insurgents with an anti-tank missile.
What's gonna happen? M16s, 240. We're gonna pop up. Gonna do 5 seconds of suppression. All right? Slow on M16s. Like 2 bursts. That way, Colt Pelton is gonna show me where the fires come from, and I can look at the building. All right? That's you and you. Ready? Set. Get a hose up.
The heavy fire keeps the insurgents' heads down. The tracer has shown the man with the missile the target.
We'll use that.
Okay.
And then
aiming in that window.
Right? That
we're
window
the
right there.
Story. It's like a doorway.
Go! Go!
The back blast of the missile engulfs everyone in dust. They call in an airstrike. And the troops must quickly leave the danger area.
Snipers are here with Captain Santos. All right, start with the guns. Guns are going first. Go, guns. Head take point. Head to bomb.
They rush down the stairs to find a new position. Fearing the insurgents may still be active, they run down the street.
Keep my gun up.
Move, gun.
The debris of the day's battle lies in their path. A rocket launcher, a flattened Kalashnikov. From a safer rooftop, we filmed tanks moving along the street, ready to fire a round into each house where there might still be resistance.
They're trying to talk to them with their interpreter, get them to surrender, walk out on the street. They're telling us they'd rather die than come out and surrender, so they're gonna die.
The Marines begin to relax. The clash is nearing its end. They've made a tactical withdrawal to this rooftop here, waiting for air power to come in and bomb the remaining insurgents. They think that there's at least another half dozen still in there.
5 seconds!
Night is falling. as the Marines go on foot to see whether the combined power of all their weaponry has destroyed their enemies.
We're gonna check out the body, sir.
In the wreckage of the houses along the street near the mosque, they find the bodies of 21 fighters. According to their documents, these five came from the neighboring town of Ramadi. Terrorists to the Americans, martyrs to those who support their cause. The end of the Muslim fast of Ramadan is marked by the sickle moon. Americans control Fallujah, the ruined city of mosques. Lindsay Hilsum, Channel 4 News, Fallujah.